Welcome to aminacademy.com. In engineering mechanics, let us do moment of inertia, that is MI. What is moment of inertia? It is measure of an object to change its rotation. Also defined as the capacity of cross section to resist bending. It must be specified with respect to a chosen axis of rotation. It is usually quantified by m power 4, that is meter power 4 or kg power 4, etc. Now let us consider a small wheel with axis is rotation. It is easy to rotate, means it is giving less resistance to rotate. At same time, consider a big wheel in axis. We have to give more force, more torque to rotate such a big wheel, means this bigger wheel have more moment of inertia than smaller wheel. Also consider a beam. Cross section of the beam may be size is big, that means area of cross section is big, means it is harder to bend than if the area of cross section is less, which is easier to bend when both materials are same. Also, that moment of inertia should be with respect to what axis we have to represent. That means the chosen axis is important of that axis of rotation. Next, moment of inertia of plane area. Let us see. Look at this figure. Here in XY plane, one lamina, plane lamina is given. That total area, suppose it is A. Now consider the plane area whose moment of inertia to be found. Split the whole area into a number of small elemental area, means A1, A2, A3, A4 and up to AN. That means that the complete lamina is split as a smaller pieces of areas. Let those areas are A1, A2, A3 and AN are areas of those elements, and consider from y axis those areas are R1, R2, R3 and ... at Rn distances from that fixed axis. Now the moment of inertia of the whole area I is A1 into R1 squared, means this area of small area and multiplication of the square of the distance, plus A2 R2 squared plus A3 R3 squared plus ... AN squared. Now totally I equals sigma AR squared. Units of moment of inertia of plane figures are mm power 4, cm power 4, m power 4, etc. M power 4 means meter power 4. Method to find moment of inertia. There are two methods here described. First method is by Ruth's rule, second by integration. Let us consider first the Ruth's rule. Moment of inertia of plane figures by Ruth's rule. The Ruth's rule states if a body is symmetrical about three mutual perpendicular axes, that is x, y, z axis, then the moment of inertia about any one axis passing through its center of gravity is given by I equal A or M into S over 3 for square and rectangular laminas for this formula. Similarly, I equal to A or M into S over 4 for circular or elliptical lamina. Another one, I equals A into A or M into S over 5 for spherical bodies, where A is area of plan lamina, M is mass of the body, S is sum of the square of two semi-axis, means x and y axis means square of x by 2 square and y by 2 square. S equal to sum of square of two semi-axis other than the axis about which the moment of inertia is required to be found. Note, this method, that is Ruth's rule, have no practical importance than integration. Method of integration is more powerful and useful for finding moment of inertia of laminar and mass of the body. Now let us find moment of a rectangular lamina having width b and depth d. Consider this rectangular lamina having width b and depth is d. By Ruth's rule, we can find moment of inertia about the axis x, that is Ixx, equal ma of rectangular lamina about xx axis. Now Ixx equal A into S over 3 by Ruth's rule, since the lamina is rectangular shape. Now S equal D over 2, D over 2 means the depth over 2 whole square plus other axis is here 0, consider 0, therefore S equal to D squared over 4. And A equal area of the lamina, that is area of the rectangle, is B into D. Now Ixx, that is moment of inertia of a rectangular lamina about axis through its center of gravity, equal A into S over 3, which is equal B into D, that is area, into D square over 4, that is S over 3. By simplification, Ixx, that is moment of inertia of the rectangular lamina about an axis which passed through center of gravity, is Ixx equal B d cube over 12.